peptide crash course. 10 peptides in 5 minutes. That's what we're going to hit today. It's Dr. Deborah Durst, and I am a specialist in hormones, regenerative medicine, and sexual wellness, and obviously peptides. We have been doing peptides for greater than 5 years, and the landscape has changed in the peptide world. It's a popular topic, but what has been available and what is available now has changed and will continue to change over the near future. So we're going to hit 10 peptides today and just approvals, you know, do they work? What is the hype? What are they used for? And so number one, let's get into it. Semaglutide. So that's a GLP-1 that is used for weight loss, and that is approved. So it has two brand names with the FDA. So one is Ozempic, and that was approved for diabetes. And then it was remarketed under the name of Wegovy. That's the first time that I have seen that. And as a pharmacist, you know, I just hadn't seen that before. I was a pharmacist before I was a physician, not practicing now, but I had never really seen that before. But the second brand name is Wegovy, and that is approved for weight loss and a varying, you know, population indication as well. Second one is tirzepatide. That is also a GLP-1, has a second receptor agonist in it. It's used for weight loss, and it is approved. So that is approved under the name of Mounjaro, and I think Zepbound is another one. And so that is true. So basically, the next one is tesamorelin. Tesamorelin is a growth hormone peptide that is approved, usually used for body composition when it was actually used off-label, but on-label is for visceral fat in an HIV-positive patient. And so the off-label indications would be body composition changes. So bremelanotide is another one. That's the fourth one, and that's PT-141. That is a sexual peptide. And so it's used to increase sex drive, but it's approved for premenopausal women with low sex drive. Off-label indications would be for men with low sex drive, men that have some erection changes that they want to see improved, so helps with ED, and for women postmenopausal as well, but better orgasmic strength across the board for women. At least that's what we're seeing in our practice. And then we'll hit some other ones that are not approved, but have been approved in the past, CJC and epamorlin being one of those. That is my favorite growth hormone peptide, or was. Basically, it stimulates your own release of growth hormone in the body, not approved, so considered investigational right now. And it is used for body composition changes because it increases your growth hormone in the body. Then we're talking about another one that actually has an approved and not approved form. So melanotan 1 and 2. 1 is approved, and it's approved for indications not related to tanning, but it works to increase tanning and increase your melanocytes in the body. And then basically melanotan 2 is a different, maybe longer version, but that is not approved. So melanotan 1 would be the one that you could get. Another not approved one is thymosin beta 4 or TB4. That's an immune modulating one. It was also used for hair stimulation. And again, the FDA has some changes that are still happening, and they're looking at some category 2 peptides to see if the safety concerns are big enough that they don't want to move them to a category 1 compounding classification or status, but we'll keep you updated. TB4 is one of them. BPC-157, that is a non-improved investigational, but again, has been in the past available, and it is a fabulous peptide for healing, natural to the gastric juices and the stomach. So it helps with GI healing, but it helps with healing of everything. And if somebody had an acute or chronic injury across the board, our patients love BPC-157, but it has been removed, so unavailable investigational right now. AOD-9064 is another one that is a small segment of growth hormone. So really used for body composition, but really fat reduction, if anything, but that is not approved currently. And then one of my favorites is GHKCU. That is approved for topical use for aesthetics. So it helps with collagen production and skin regeneration. But it also could potentially be used in a systemic fashion, but that is not approved for use right now. So again, I think never get peptides offline. You don't know what you're getting. You don't know about potency. The sourcing is pretty much all the same, you know, for either compounded or manufactured versions of those. And so obviously, if you're getting it for a lower price, that sourcing isn't of quality. And you don't know what you're getting. You don't know what else is in there. So don't do black market peptides. Don't do online. They need to be written by a physician, and you need to obtain them from an FDA-regulated pharmacy. So a pharmacy that that physician may use and trust is how you should be using peptides. And then you need to be monitored closely by a physician or provider that has specialized in peptides. So that is my lowdown on peptides. Again, nothing on the black market. Get it from a physician that's specialized. And there's some that are approved, some that aren't approved. Across the board, a peptide is effective if it has shown kind of studies that have shown improvement, but they're not going to be large studies. They're going to be smaller studies right now because they are a new and progressive area of medicine. But look for this area and this landscape to change quite a bit over the next year or two. So hopefully that helps. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know your experience with peptides so far, and look forward to talking soon.